welcome back to Carolyn's Cozy Kitchen. I've had some requests, so I wanted today to show you how I make my meatloaf. And once again, my son and I are actually eating a lean and green diet, so I'm gonna tweak the recipe a little bit, but I'll tell you what I normally do as well. And that is, I actually get about a pound and a half of ground turkey, and instead of using breadcrumbs, which I use about a cup actually of breadcrumbs, finely chopped breadcrumbs, I'm using a low-fat mozzarella cheese. I'm also adding a dry onion soup mix, and you can use any package of dry onion soup mix that you would like. So if you have a requirement for lower salt or different, you know, no sugars, for example, anything like that, we're actually staying away from sugar. So that's an important thing for us now. And I'm gonna use my deep covered baker. My deep covered baker is an awesome tool, and it's something that I use on a regular basis as well. I wanted to go ahead and put my meatloaf together because I actually cook my meatloaf about an hour and 15 minutes. So I'm gonna put my meatloaf together, and then I'm gonna show you a great additive for vegetables around the edge of my deep covered baker so that you can have a complete meal in one pot. So I'm gonna start with my ground turkey. Like I said, it's a pound and a half of ground turkey. And I'm going to add my cup of low-fat mozzarella cheese to the mix here. And normally I use ketchup within my mix, but because ketchup is actually 3/4 of it is sugar, I'm trying to stay away from it. So I am in my manual food processor. I did process a little bit of tomatoes, peppers, and onions, and that's actually all it is. So I'm gonna add that for the liquid part to my meat, and that's about 3/4 of a cup, maybe a little bit less than 3/4 of a cup. And I'm also going to add some pesto. I like the addition of, this is homemade pesto actually, but it's basil from my yard, it's garlic. It does have a little bit of non-fat cheese in it, and you can pick any kind of nuts that you choose. So, whether it's in macadamia nuts for Hawaii, if you have a special taste, you can add macadamia nuts even to your pesto. So I'm gonna do that, and this is, like I had mentioned before, this is dry onion soup mix. And this is actually a key because it has a lot of really good flavors in it. And it doesn't, it won't hurt you, but it's really good. And so I'm gonna use this. This actually, I use my, they have skinny scrapers. This is actually a classic scraper, which I use a lot just because I like it to be a little bit wider, but there are people that like the skinnier version of the scrapers. But Pampered Chef scrapers and any kind of pans and utility spoons, anything like that, they last so long. So once you get them, you never have to buy them again. So it's always a good investment for your kitchen. So I'm gonna do this. Also, I do add one egg because the egg is kind of what holds it together. So between the egg and the low-fat cheese, it helps you to hold your meatloaf together. And it's super yummy, I'm gonna tell you that. So, okay, I don't wanna gross anyone out, but I actually use my hands to put my meatloaf together because when I put it in the deep covered baker, this is a stone, the deep covered baker, so you don't have to use any kind of sprays or grease to grease it, because actually it's a benefit to you for the food that you prepare to season it. So I'm gonna put this together. But normally, like I said, and it does taste really good. If you use breadcrumbs, it's really good. So I'm gonna do this. So you make your meatloaf, and you know what? You cook it on at 350, And like I said, I cook it for an hour and 15 minutes just to make sure that the inside is completely done. The breadcrumbs does make it a little bit more firm, and it doesn't change anything about the way it turns out, however, but when you're making the loaf itself, it helps it to be a little bit firm. Wash my hands, especially, I don't know about every place else, but in Hawaii right now, we have a lot of illness going around, so I always recommend washing my hands. Washing your hands, okay. So, this is my meatloaf. This is actually what it looks like. Like I said, this is turkey meatloaf, and it is low-fat meat, low-fat Parmesan, or mozzarella cheese, sorry, low-fat mozzarella cheese, and I had made my own salsa. So I have my oven set at 350, and I'm gonna actually put it in the oven uncovered because I want it to brown a little bit. Oh, speaking of which, I did mention that normally I put a little bit of ketchup in to make it a little bit moister. However, because of the high salt or the high sugar content, I'm using a low sugar and low fat ketchup, and all I'm actually using this for is to make it look pretty. So as you're baking it, the ketchup on the top just gives it a shiny. This is, so you just cover it with a light coating of ketchup. And like I said, I am choosing to use a lower sugar, lower fat ketchup. And then you just put it in your oven, uncovered, for an hour and 15 minutes. Hi, welcome back to Carolyn's Cozy Kitchen. I do have my meatloaf in the oven, and I have set the timer for an hour. And I wanted to show you how I chop my vegetables to put around the outside of my deep covered baker. Because it, like I said, it kind of makes the one pot meal idea. And I like to have vegetables, so it's a good choice as well. So I wanted to show you, I'm going to add zucchini, mushroom, and onion to the outer rim of my meatloaf. And I'm gonna use my quick slice to do my mushrooms. So I have my mushrooms here already washed, and it makes it really easy. You don't have to spend a lot of time in your kitchen preparing. You can do this in advance, so you can have a bag of already sliced mushrooms for the week or zucchini. So it does help you in your meal preparation for lunches or for dinner. So if you don't have a lot of time in the evening after you get home from work, then it's always a good idea to prep your vegetables ahead of time. But I wanted to show you this because it makes it so easy to do. You just cut your mushrooms. That's why they call it a quick slice, because you can do it very easily. So it makes everything easy. And that's what one of the mottos in Carolyn's Cozy Kitchen is, that we want to make sure that when we're making healthy and, you know, healthy and good food for our families, that it doesn't take a lot of time, because it takes a lot of time to do things normally. So I want to help you with that. It makes it more enjoyable for everybody, because then you can spend good quality time with your kids, and you can do the things that you need to do to prepare for other things. I myself homeschool my kids, so we're home a lot, and I like to spend some time outside as well. So I'm gonna show you how easy this is. Look at this. So this is my last mushroom already. Okay, so look at that. In that little bit of time, I have already chopped these mushrooms. And like I said, you can bag them. I'd recommend that if you bag them, you put a dry paper towel within it, so it does absorb some of the moisture. That works very handy for me. And I'm gonna chop some onions. So this is my manual food processor. I'll show you what it looks like inside. I put onions in there, and for preppers or people that are concerned at all about emergencies, you don't have to use electricity, so you always have something like this handy. I really like mine. So it's that easy to chop onions. The manual food chopper. And this is awesome because if you're making salads a lot or you're trying to do hot vegetables, this is actually a simple slicer. You could do all kinds of things on this. It does come with a top that you can use, but with zucchini, for what I'm doing, all you have to do is slice it like this. Really fast. In my mixing bowl sets, and I love my glass mixing bowl sets because I use them for everything as well. But also, this makes your meal kind of uniform. Your vegetables are not some big, some small. It looks like a professional dinner. So, okay, we're not perfect, but we are pampered chefs, so we might as well enjoy the opportunity to do things well and get credit for it. How's that? So, this is our simple slice. So, look at that. It works awesome, just like that. And also with the quick slicer, with things like this, you can actually cut eggs. And for those of us in Hawaii, you can put spam in here to make spam musubi, and it makes 8 perfect slices. So you can't beat that. So we are considerate of cultural issues. And in Hawaii, we have a lot of food related cultural issues. Okay, so I'm gonna put my cut mushrooms, my zucchini, and my onion in my bowl here. And I'm going to show you that I have what I call, I've shown it before, but I have what I call a kitchen spritzer. And in my kitchen spritzer, I have olive oil. And so you can actually put dressings that are thin in this. I don't use aerosols generally in my kitchen. If you need to spray or prepare a pan for baking, for example, you can use this kitchen spritzer. What I'm going to use it for now is just to put a little bit of olive oil on my vegetable mixture so that it just looks nice. And then when I, it doesn't add a ton of it, so you're not having oil of any kind dripping from your vegetables or your pan. So that always works nicely for me. I like pepper. But actually, I like pepper so much that we have this great crushed pepper and garlic rub that I like a lot. It has a really great flavor. You can taste it. It's not like prepared spices that have been sitting in your cabinet and don't use. I guarantee you will use it often. And that's called the crushed pepper. Hi, welcome back to Carolyn's Cozy Kitchen. An hour and 15 minutes has passed, and now we have our lean and green meatloaf with our vegetable side in one pan. Let me show you. This is, like I said, in our deep covered baker, but we don't need to bake the meatloaf with the lid on. But it's a great way to keep it warm. So after you have your meatloaf done, you can keep it warm on the stove, and you don't want to reheat it on the stove, but you can keep it warm on the stove with the lid. But take a look at this. This is good. Meatloaf, lean and green turkey meatloaf with vegetables. We have mushrooms, zucchini, and onions. And I thank you for coming to Carolyn's Cozy Kitchen. And don't forget, like and subscribe. And turn on post notifications so that you can see and you don't miss out on any more adventures from Carolyn's Cozy Kitchen. Aloha! Mm-hmm.